Right, just popping out, but I had this idea for keeping the wider upper arm angle. It's a very simple little thing. I'm using my son's Spider-Man lunchbox, so the amazing Spider-Man. Stick into the crook of your arm like that. Get yourself an angle of at least 90 degrees between upper arm and shoulder. Maybe a little bit wider if you want, but I prefer in there. Disc in there, hand on the outside. And what we're going to do basically, using the other hand here, just hold in place. Strapping it in place would be great, but I haven't done that. Is come back, come in, come out. So as simple as that. Go back, in, out. And that should stop you from collapsing that upper angle shoulder, which is a problem of getting collapsing that way or coming around and collapsing that way and coming there. So by keeping it in there, it should force the arm out away from the body on the way out. So looking at it from this way around, that's where I'm there. Triceps facing down the target line. Shift back, down, out. And see how we come off the line. I'm not sure if you can see the line of the bench here. So that's going to be my pull, my target line is down there. So my triceps facing down the target line. We go back, in, and then off the line. And just line that up slightly better so you can see it. Yeah, so in there, crook of the arm, that there on the outside. Back, down, and then off and away down there. So you're going off the line on the way out. You're not trying to pull through the line, so that'd be pulling down that line there. You're trying to go back and then unload the lower arm. So the lower arm is swinging out from there. It's not being pulled out there by the shoulder. It's swinging out from the elbow. You're coming down, bang. It's that bang, that hammering nail. Get a claw hammer into it. Releasing the hammerhead. Bang. But it comes out off the line. That jump from here out there. Huge extension there, extend out, and even though it feels like you're shifting your weight offline, it's all going into the disc, which is then going down this line. So you're shifting your weight, everything going through down here, but the disc is flying out down here. So yeah, it's basically keeping that all in position. I don't know why I'm making that sound for it. Try and feel that position and replicate it. Right, I've got to go.